So I just realized that we passed 1,000 subscribers already, and that is crazy, that is insane, in not even 2 months. So I decided I want to give you guys something, and what you're getting is a small script I made. I actually made this script for my exam, but you can have it as well. It's a couple of buttons that will help you change your scene back and forth between VR images and your regular renders. So that's coming up. Hello YouTube, I am Kevin the Dane, and on this channel I'm giving you tips, tricks and tutorials to help you master 3D Studio Max and VRay. Today I've created a script for you and there is a link to download it somewhere up here and in the description as well. But first of all, a big thank you to all you guys who subscribed already. I am so grateful and thankful and honored that this many people are following along. And you guys are asking so many great questions, I think I have to do a video Q&A soon. So keep the questions coming and I'll try to answer as many as possible in the comment section below. Now back to the giveaway. So if you download the script and meet me on 3D Studio Max, I'll show you how to set it up and what you can do with it. The scene I have here is just a room I use for testing VR images. If we render it out, you will see that it is just a cube with a checker map and a few lights. The macro scripts are two buttons that I've made to make it easy to switch render settings and to set up VR stereo renders. So to install it, you first need to extract the file somewhere, and then you open up the folder and drag the install file into Max. You're prompted to accept the installation, and afterwards a dialog box tells you how to set up the UI, but I'm gonna show you that right now, so just click OK. Right-click the UI somewhere and choose Customize. Pick the toolbar tab, and under Category, go down and select Kevin the Dane. From here you can drag the buttons onto any toolbar in the UI. For this purpose, let's create a new toolbar and call it Kevin the Dane. You can call it whatever you like, of course. Move the toolbar wherever you want it, and now let's drag the macro scripts out on the new toolbar. The cube icon is for making 12x1 stereo cube images, and the sphere icon is for making spherical stereo images. So if you click the cube button, you will notice that the image aspect ratio have changed, and that is because we are now rendering a 12x1 cube image. So let's hit render and see how it works. So now that the render is done, you can save it out and you can view it in your device. If you want to learn how to do that, I've created a video specifically for Gear VR, and I will put the link in the description for that as well. When you are done rendering, just uncheck the button again and you are back to your original settings and your original render dimensions. The sphere button works the same, just for rendering spherical stereo images. The render dimensions used are the full resolution settings for use for the Samsung Gear VR. Once you click the button, you can manually tweak them in the render settings dialog if you need to. If you have a Gear VR or about to buy one, I have a VR game going into beta testing soon, so if you sign up for the newsletter, I will send you a free beta key once I move the game into beta testing. If you don't have a Gear VR but you want to buy one, I have an Amazon affiliate link down below. If you use that when you buy, you will help support this channel so that I can help you master VRay and 3D Studio Max. I've set up the link to take you to your local Amazon, so I hope it works for everyone. If you're looking to support this channel in other ways, I have just set up a Patreon account so you can go there and become a patron. There will be special rewards for the first ones, like free video games and a permanent place in the Hall of Fame. And as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, tweet, whatever floats your boat, and cut! Back and forth between VR, back and forth between VR. There's a link, and meet me on 3D Studio Max. I will see you there. No, I will eat a muffin.